Hello and welcome to today's expert webinar presented by Accountants World. We will be getting started in just about 5 minutes here with Hitendra Patil talking about CAS from zero. I want to thank you again for joining us today. My name is Div Bansali. I'm a vice president at Accountants World. We're excited to have you on board today, hearing somebody who's not only one of the experts in the field of client accounting services, but also my colleague for a number of years as well. So very excited to have you on board today. For those of you who have not used the GoToWebinar tool in a while, a couple of quick tips. If you don't see the GoToWebinar control panel, you can look for an orange arrow that will expand or hide the panel anytime you want to. If you'd like to change your audio options, you can go to the audio tab and then select either computer speakers or telephone. If you click on the phone option, it will then give you a call-in number and an access code as well. I mentioned before about the handouts. If you haven't downloaded Hitendra's presentation yet as a PDF, that's available under the handouts tab. And also, if you have any questions for Hitendra during the presentation, go ahead and write those in at any time. Hitendra will be answering those at the end of the presentation. So keep them coming at any point. Also, just wanted to mention, if you look in the bottom left of my slides, you'll see hashtag expert webinar. So if you're on Twitter, you can go ahead and summarize anything you hear or anything you think is interesting, or if you have questions for ourselves, for us, Tom Provine on our team will be on Twitter during today's presentation and happy to answer any questions that you have at that time as well. Hashtag expert webinar. We do offer one CP for this webinar today. And that's based on active participation during the presentation. Active participation means you are logged into the event for a minimum of 50 minutes. You respond to all of the poll questions in the webinar, and you complete the survey at the end of the webinar. The survey launches after the webinar window is closed. If you don't see it, no worries, we'll send you a link to the survey by email afterwards. CPE eligibility will be confirmed sometime next week, so look for a confirmation of that. Before we get started, a brief word about our sponsor today, Accountants World. And specifically, since we're talking about client accounting services today, Accountants World has a leading solution built specifically to handle the rigors of client accounting services, and it's called Accounting Power. Hitendra will be telling you a little bit about it later on, but basically what client accounting services really relies on is a professional grade solution where you can best serve the needs of every single client, whatever their specific requirements might be. And so Accounting Power was the first professional accounting system that combined a full professional system with all the capabilities you see on the right-hand side there, along with a comprehensive bookkeeping system as well. And so by having those two things coupled and giving you the access to be able to give each of your clients permission to use only the functions that they're prepared to use and well trained to use, you can make sure that you can do the work that your staff, that your client staff currently does if you choose to do that and if your clients want that, but you can do it faster, easier, and more accurately, and often at less cost to the client as well. For clients who want to continue to do some of the work, you can give them permissions to do that, and you have one unified system, so you don't have bookkeeping errors and waiting for file transfers and versions of software and all the other issues that we have in the predominant accounting module that's out there right now. So if you'd like to learn more about Accounting Power after today's presentation, you can visit accountingpower.com, learn more about it, view our 3-minute video, and also schedule a live one-on-one demo when you're ready to. Before I turn it over to Hitendra, a quick word about Hitendra Patil. He's the Director of Customer Success at Accountants World. Hitendra is an expert in how to apply both current and emerging technologies to further the accounting client relationship. And that's been a focus of his for many, many years. As a result of his breakthrough publishing and work in that area, Hitendra has been twice selected as one of the top 100 most influential people in accounting by Accounting Today. So at this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Hitendra Patil.
Thank you, Dave. Tom, can you switch over the screen to mine?
I'll go ahead and switch it over in just a second here. You should see it momentarily.
Okay. Human screen. All right, Tom, do you see presenter screen or the full screen?
I see everything, Hitendra. I think we're ready to go.
Okay, so perfect. All right. So let's dive in. Thank you, Dev, for the kind introduction. And welcome everyone to this webinar about client accounting services, CAS. I call it CAS. And I will use the word CAS throughout this webinar to mean client accounting services. It may sound like cash, C-A-S-H, and it does mean more cash for accounting firms. There is a thin line between success in CAS or otherwise. What does this line mean? We will come to it soon. So in today's webinar, we will quickly touch upon the why and what of CAS, because we need to relate the how of the CAS to the underlying market dynamics. We learn these changing dynamics day in, day out here at Accountants World, because we sell only to accountants, not to their clients. So we interact only with accounting firms. We will also cover insights on market dynamics that we gathered from a definitive CAS survey that CPA Trendlines conducted in late June this year. And it is perhaps the most responded to CAS survey ever that I have seen. Then we will go to the how to cover some of the important practical steps that you can take to launch your CAS or enhance it if you already have it. And as promised, to appreciate your time and commitment to make your CAS practice a success, we will share with you the CAS assessment wizard. It is basically a simple Excel file so that there is no big curve, learning curve to use it, and you can just start implementing that right in your practice on a day-to-day basis. Actually, it is not just one bonus that I'm giving away. You will also get two more, a total of three practical tools that you can possibly use in your CAS practice. What are those tools? Stay tuned. So before we begin, can we launch the poll number one, please?
Sounds good. I will go ahead and launch that first poll question. So folks, you should see the first poll question in front of you right now. And so the question is, does your firm currently offer client accounting services or CAS? So yes, we're considering it. We have no plans to offer CAS at this time. What is CAS? If you don't know what it is, no worries. Go ahead and select that one, or we are not an accounting firm. So please select the option that best represents you. Make sure to click the submit button so that your vote is counted. And just a reminder, this is the first of three poll questions today that are required in order to earn CPE credit. All right, so we'll give about, I see about 85% of people have voted now, so please go ahead and get your vote in if you haven't already done so. We'll give about 10 more seconds here. All right, I'm going to go ahead and close out the poll. Going once, going twice. All right, so Hitendra, we see 59% of people said yes, they do currently offer CAS. 23% are considering it.
Okay, 59 is good percentage. Compared to last year, I would say it's 20-25% more, so which is really, really good. And plus 23% looking to offer, that's even better. So, which means the attendees in this room are going to see something really, really relevant, which is really, really good. Okay. So we now live in different times. According to Google search, I saw that the first real accounting tool, Abacus, was invented some 500 years before Christ. And then it took literally centuries to move further on tools and technology used in accounting. It was late 1950s that mainframe computers came in and accounting started getting digitized. Desktop in 1975 turned everything on its head. And then in 1990 came the internet, and which gave rise to the cloud in the late 2000s. And now we are hearing terms automation, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and stuff like that. And what it actually did is, according to Statista, between the year 2008 and 2016, about 21% people stopped buying services from professional accountants. That is roughly about 7 million people who were accountants' customers that ceased to be accountants' customers. I'm sharing these statistics not to make you feel worried, but to ensure that we are looking at the realities of the marketplace in identical ways, and to share ways to turn the perceived adversity into opportunities for accountants. If technological advances made it possible for accountants' clients to feel that they can do accounting themselves, what does it really mean for accountants? The common thread is to win in a different world, you will need to provide services differently. Different world demands different strategies for success. And the research proves that CAS is one of the topmost new success strategies for accounting firms of all sizes. Accounting has been and is still one of the most profitable professions in this country. But what made accounting firms successful till now are not the factors that will continue to bring you success in the future. Let me share a couple of quick examples. Meet Stephen Brewer, one of the firms in a small town in Indiana. He is one of our esteemed customers here at Accountants World. 65% of Steve's revenue now comes from CAS and CFO services. Now, this figure was just about 25% 4 to 5 years ago. Now, he has also achieved 75% revenue growth in last 5 years. He now has 35 clients in 20 different states, serving all of them from his office in Indiana. And most notably, his number of clients has not changed at all. Now, how did Steve manage to get where he is now? It all started with the recognition that he needed to change his services mix to align with the changing expectations of his clients and prospects in a different world. Let's take another quick example. Meet Jim Sosinski. He's also one of our customers. And after implementing CAS, here is what happened to Jim's calendar. The red color indicates a busier time, more stress, and stretch. Notice the difference of how much less red his year is now. Nearly 50% less red. Now, Jim says CAS means as live as possible, as live as possible. And it helps him distribute the workload equitably across more months in the year and have clients much more tax ready than ever before. Let's come to the why. There are three whys you want to embrace to be successful in your CAS offering. For your CAS services to be bought, your clients must feel the need or want it. It is already happening in the different world that we live in. That is the why before you decide why your firm should offer CAS. Now, client expectations are changing and changing rapidly. They may not express it clearly. Your client's new needs and wants are your first why. And once you recognize and embrace that first why, the second why is automatically answered. So why do clients need CAS now? What changed? I get this question often. And clients' expectations have changed enough now, and that makes CAS a necessity. Remember, we live in a different world altogether now. I will explain this a bit more in the upcoming slides. I picked 6 of the 18 common CAS questions that I've been hearing for the last almost 3 years. And these 6 questions are those that I feel are important for your CAS practice. Now, if you look at the whole scenario over the last many years, prior to the emergence of new technologies, especially the internet, that gave birth to the accounting software on the cloud, business owners, that's your clients, used desktop accounting software more as a business operations software and less as accounting software. There was no easy and fast way for accountants to access that software. It all was changing over the last few years. Now, with collaborative, real-time, online sharing of the same accounting software, accountants can work with the business owners, not just after the business decisions are made by them, but actually more so while and even before they make those business decisions. More and more business owners are now aware that cloud helps them work with professional accountants in real time. Now, these possibilities did not exist before, with technology reducing the data-intensive work and hence cost of processing work going down. Professional accounting work and insights from it have become more affordable for millions of more smaller businesses that were not engaging accountants before. So I believe the newer technologies are helping accountants get back those lost clientele that was lost in the year 2008 to 2016. I will cover answers to some of these common questions in the next few slides. So this slide is going to be with you. So when you decide about your CAS practice, go back to this slide and try and answer these questions. Okay. What is CAS? Now let's address this fundamental question first, because there seems to be a lot of confusion about it. What you see on this slide is a very common essence of the CAS content that you can easily find on the internet. So I will not spend too much time on this slide. But my insights are marked in the text in yellow color here. Those words can serve as your CAS action points or CAS goals. How fast can you go from level 1 to level 4? It will depend upon your actions. So let me take one quick example here. From the experience of our users of Accounting Power, we learned that bank feeds automation can reduce the write-up or after-the-fact processing time by as much as 90 to 95% if you implement it correctly. And even if you put just 50% of your write-up clients on bank feeds, you will see an increase of about 30% in net profit from that work. And if you can get new clients quickly, it can increase your revenue by 70 to 75% and profit by 100 to 125% without adding any new staff. CAS essentially means your ability to do what is best for all your clients and at the same time do what is best for your firm. Now, let me come to something that you will not find on the internet about CAS. Any person who has ever traded on a stock exchange will quickly understand this particular slide. There are sellers asking for a price and there are buyers who are bidding at a price. When the ask and bid match, there is a trade. Now, how does this relate to CAS? Let me show you. Just like in the stock exchanges, there is a time when the trade is formed. In CAS realm, that time is when your clients are making their business decisions. As an accountant, it should be easier for you to know what that timeline is. And of course, your clients make several business decisions. The impact of those decisions is reflected in accounting, or more importantly, accounting insights can impact your client's business decisions if you offer CAS. How? Let's see. There is enough evidence in the market that clients are willing to pay higher price if they can get professional help during and before the time they make their business decisions. But they're not willing to pay more after the decisions that they made in their business. Hence, the lower priced write-up services are also called after the fact. Now, there is still value that you can generate from after the fact work and deliver insights on that. But if you can create and sell your services during and before the time when your clients make your business decisions, you will make more from the same time and resources you have, and more often than not, from the same existing clients you have now. Remember Steven Brewer? His number of clients did not change much, but the composition of his services changed. It moved towards the upper side of the business decision timeline, and the client mix changed too. I have added some examples of the services that can be offered based on this timeline, just to get you started with CAS. You can adjust it as you gain CAS experience with your own clients and prospects. Now, if you feel this might need more resources, it can be costly, etc., let me share some very fresh CAS market insights with you. CPA Trendlines did a CAS survey in late June 2019. That's a very fresh survey, and shared with me some of the top line executive summary results. Now, this survey was only about CAS. over 8,000 accountants responded to the initial survey, and over 650 responded to the detailed survey later. 9 out of 10 survey respondents are firm owners, partners, or decision makers at their firms. Firms of all sizes responded to the survey. 88% agreed that CAS is important for their firm's future. There are many more insights in this report, and you can obtain this top line executive summary results report when you take this 4 to 8 minute survey. The survey link is here. It's also included in the handouts, and I believe you will receive an email with the link as well after the webinar is over. Now, here are some relevant insights from that particular survey. From the firms that offered CAS services, 83% agree that CAS attracts new clients. It solves one of your biggest problems that accountants have, getting new clients. 84% agree CAS creates new opportunities. 88%, and this is the largest number on this slide, 88% agree that CAS provides more client satisfaction. Now, this in turn results in multiplying your referrals. 75% agree CAS provides superior revenue growth. And this is a telling slide. The number of services that are included in CAS offering. From the firms that participated in the survey and were not offering CAS, non-CAS firms, the average came to about 4 to 5 services that they were offering. CAS firms, on the other hand, offered nearly 10 services, nearly double the number of services. Basically, it tells you what is the volume of money that you might leave on table if you're not offering CAS. To the surprise of some accountants, but almost as we anticipated here at Accountants World, payroll processing and payroll compliance services are among the top 7 CAS services offered by CAS firms. Now, all of these results from the survey, and there are more, show that CAS is a must-offer, profitable, new revenue segment for your firm. And if you're already offering CAS, you want to enhance it. And to help you do so, I'm about to share some tools that have proven to work. Let's see what those are. But before we go there, can we launch poll number 2, please?
Yep, we'll go ahead and get the second poll up. All right, folks, so you should see the second poll question open in front of you now. And the question is, what is stopping you from offering CAS or growing your current CAS practice? And so there are 4 options there, and then the 5th option is nothing stopping me. So if you feel like you are full steam ahead and there are no major barriers, you can go ahead and select that one. Otherwise, select whichever of these is most applicable to you.
Hello, Div. Your microphone is a little bit scratchy coming through. If you won't mind, I'm just going to read the poll question to our audience.
Sure.
Okay. So hi, folks. I'm Tom Provine. I'm a marketing coordinator here at Accountants World. I've been in the background answering some of your questions. So I will read the second poll question to you. What is stopping you from offering CAS or growing your current CAS practice? Is it not enough staff? Do you not have the right technology? It is too costly to offer CAS? I do not see the need, or not in public accounting? And nothing is stopping me. All right, and it looks like it's already been closed here, so I will share the results with everybody. All right, what is stopping you from offering CAS? So, Hitendra, it looks like nothing is stopping anybody. About half the audience has said that they are offering CAS. Mm-hmm. One measure is that there is not enough staff. Mm-hmm. And 14% said they do not have the right technology. Now, do you find that that's concurrent with your findings and your expertise?
Yes, that's definitely in line with what we've been seeing in the profession. Even the CAS survey results did show that one of the topmost reasons was a shortage of staff. And I'm going to throw some light on that. Technology is also something that people struggle with, especially when they're starting CAS. But again, we have some answers from the firms that have been doing this very successfully. All right, so Are you able to see my screen, Tom?
Yes, I am.
Okay, perfect. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, so let's come to the CAS assessment wizard. As promised, we will share with you the CAS assessment wizard, which is a tool that you can use in your CAS practice. Basically, how the tool is designed, and it's a simple Excel file that you can easily use. There is no learning curve in using it. Is you ask a few questions, answer a few questions about your client or a prospect. And while you're answering those questions, you will view real-time results of the assessment. And based on the score, based on the assessment, you will see what level of CAS services you can possibly offer to that prospect or a client. And then you can review the fee potential for that level. And you can customize by adding your own fee structure in there. And once you use this, you use it with a few clients, you repeat and refine that tool for you to be able to get a full grasp of how to assess and what fees you can charge. So basically, this is how the tool looks like. I have blurred the image in some sections because this tool is being made available only to those who attended this webinar. So one fundamental thing that this tool helps you is that you won't forget to ask some important questions to assess the CAS fit of a prospect or a client. And that's not really all. The next tab in the tool gives you a list of services you can offer in each CAS level. It is prepared from the same CAS survey results that we just now talked about. You can customize it, you can add a few services in there, you can add your pricing for each service, and it will compute how much you can quote for your CAS service. So you don't really want to leave money on the table for every client and every prospect that you deal with. Then I was told by many accountants that a new client onboarding is a difficult task. So I added a suggested template for client onboarding so that you don't miss out on the key important information to ask from your new clients. And that's also included in this tool that you can use now. How do you find clients for your CAS offering? This is one of the top six questions I get about CAS all the time. And the place to start is your existing clients. They are your best bet for your CAS offering. How do you pitch CAS to them? You will find a fairly detailed answer in our CAS guide. And I have shared the link for you to download it. Now, with your existing clients, you basically look for power moments to make a difference. You need to be alert whenever you're interacting with your clients. They express their frustrations. They express aha moments. Now, those are the things that will tell you, oh, here is something that the client does not have or might need. And that's the service that you want to pitch in. But obviously, you don't want to make it sound too salesy. So you possibly say something like, okay, here is something that our existing clients, which are in similar types of businesses like yours, look at these reports and make these kind of business decisions, and these are the benefits that they get from it. So basically, you make them aware of the possibilities. The next thing that I hear from the market is the number two source, or one of the top five sources, I should say, for accountants to get new clients is when businesses move accounting from their in-house operation to the accounting firm. Then there are customers who switch accountants. Hopefully it doesn't happen to you, but if somebody is switching from another accountant to you, you definitely want to figure out what were the pain points, hurting things that made them take switching decisions, and you want to make sure that you don't fall in the same trap. Make sure that experience changes when they start working with you. Another bigger source that I've been recently told many, many times in the last many weeks and months is startups, especially the startups that have good enough venture capital funding. Now, because of venture capital funding, there's immense pressure on the founders of startups, and they're trying all their best to get new clients in, new revenue in, and make it profitable. So they don't have too much time for accounting left. And in any case, they depend a lot on accounting to see what's happening with their financials. So those are the people you need to pitch into. There are some unconventional sources of getting new clients. I was told by some firms in recent times that they look at job advertisement boards. And if somebody has posted ad for a part-time accounting position within a company, they go and pitch their services to those companies. Then you take a look at Bureau of Labor Statistics. This is a publicly available data that you can easily download for free. They publish things like 10 years projections on fastest growing occupations, 10 year projections on high wage occupations and things like that. What it tells you is which are the professions, niches, industries that will see growth over the next 10 years. And if you can, you want to focus on getting clients from those industries and niches. So these are just some of the sources that you can get your new clients from. But again, your existing clients are your best bet because you already have relationships with them. You can see their books and figure out which one will become a good CAS fit for you. Okay, so before we go to your CAS practice and how to get it rolling, let's launch poll number three, please.
Okay, poll three is open for everybody. So do you have a defined plan to start or grow your CAS practice? And so you can say, yes, our plan is underway, no, but we're working on it, or we have no plans to offer CAS at this time, or the final option, we are not a public accounting firm as well. All right, so we've got over 80% of people having voted so far. So folks, if you could please go ahead and get your vote in the next 10 seconds, if you haven't already done so. Okay, we're going once, going twice. Okay, so Hitendra, 55% of people, just over half, say no, but we're working on it. 23% say yes, our plan is underway.
Okay, that sounds pretty interesting. Okay, 20. All right, so I think let me cover in any case, I'm taking the baseline and trying to share what works, what doesn't work, and things like that. So do you see, I think you have to give me back the screen.
Okay. Yep, got it.
Okay. All right, so let's come to your CAS practice. It all starts with you. If you are the decision maker at your firm, your CAS practice really starts with you. You are the professional accountant, not your clients. If you put all your clients in one room and ask them a question, raise your hand if you love doing accounting. I'm sure very few hands will go up, if at all any. You do the professional work and help them do theirs. Let me dive into the 90-day plan for CAS success. Starting your CAS practice is not transformation. It is not an extreme makeover. It is not overwhelming. It is more of metamorphosis. It is a process even the most traditional firms can implement it. What I'm about to share is derived from the real-life experience of several accounting firms offering CAS and also from those who are yet to offer CAS. So let me share the collective proven process that you can adapt in your CAS practice. Now, CAS can literally multiply your revenue. Now, here is a quick sample of what we learned from our own customers here. We mapped the information to the statistics publicly available. Now, the opportunities are significantly larger. I know of a firm that signs up with only those clients that can give $60,000 a year engagement to the firm. So the figures that you see on screen are easily achievable. And you will see that in the CAS assessment wizard as well. Now here is the bird's eye view of what you can do to start seeing profit by the end of 90 days from starting your CAS segment. First 30 days of this 90-day cycle are the most important part. So I will explain that in much more detail than the 60 to 90 days and the 61 to 31 to 60 days thing. In the first 30 days, you build the foundation for your CAS success. In the next 30 days, you're basically learning from your CAS experience and fine-tuning your processes. And in the last 30 days part, you scale your CAS offering. Let's see this in a little more detail. In the first 30 days, as I said, you're building the foundation and you got to get a few things right in those 30 days. And two of the biggest CAS success factors have to be managed correctly within the first 30 days. One is getting the CAS fit clients, and two, creating a foundation for a profitable pricing. The CAS fit assessment tool that we will email you will make your first task easier. Now, what you do basically is you're going to select a few existing clients. You gain experience by offering CAS to them. And while you're working on CAS for them, you optimize your processes with them. So for example, how do you select a good existing client for CAS? If you're fixing clients' messy books regularly, repeatedly, that is a client fit for CAS at some level. If your client's accounting staff has left or is leaving, you can pitch CAS. Client has part-time accounting staff, you can pitch CAS, except when it's client's spouse or offspring of sibling who's the in-house accountant, don't go and pitch CAS there, of course. Volume, 100 or more invoices or bills a month, it could be a good CAS prospect. Then we are looking at right communication within the firm, with your partners, to your staff, then outside the firm to your existing clients and to the prospects. With the internal resources, your partners and your staff, what you're trying to tell them is CAS is not an additional stretch for you. CAS is an optimization of your knowledge and expertise, because technology is going to help us make sure that we leverage your brains even more and hence help our firm progress in terms of profitability, revenue, and growth. To your clients, you're going to tell something different. That is, what have they been missing? To your prospects, you're going to tell what you learn from your clients. Okay, with some of the things that clients express sometimes very innocuously are your marketing keywords. You got to pay close attention to what your clients are saying. Then you're defining your CAS components and processes correctly in the first 30 days. When I say components, basically what type of services that you're going to offer to your clients. You might be adding a few services. It might depend upon the niches that you focus on, or it might depend upon the processes where your clients seek the most help from. Whatever is hurting the client in the entire process flow, that could be one of your pitch for getting the CAS client in. And that could become one of these. For example, if somebody has a lot of payables, managing payables, accounting payables, could be a service that will be very useful for some of your clients. Then you're talking about right service deliverables. If you continue to deliver what you're delivering now to your clients and then go and say, oh, we are offering you CAS and hence you pay me more, that's not going to happen. So clients must see some difference. And what could be that difference? You got to literally put the two deliverables side by side. Okay, this is now and this is future. This is the extra in the future. This is what was missing from the now. This is what it means for the client. These are the business decisions that the clients can take now from the additional information or insight that we can deliver. So those are the deliverables that you're going to show to your clients. Okay, and of course, at the end of it, to the prospects. And only after you've defined all of this, then you come to the right technology stack. Okay, I did see some survey respondents poll respondents saying that technology is something that they're not too sure about in CAS. And let me dive a little off topic here. When we are talking about technology stack, it does not mean that you need a lot of technologies to be successful in CAS. What you definitely need is figuring out whether your current software allows you to do certain things technologically with least possible effort and hence lesser cost? Or are you doing certain steps manually all the time, repetitive steps? And then you go and see how can you find a solution or solutions that can make those manual steps electronic and possibly integrated and automated solutions. So you're not talking of multiple solutions in a stack, but you're definitely talking of solutions that reduce your manual work at your office. And then only at the end of all of this, you come to the right pricing. Now, experience tells that you want to keep the pricing agreement open for 90 days. So when you sign up with a CAS client, the engagement letter, the clause must say that we will revisit the pricing after 90 days of working on this engagement, and we will work together with you to fix the future pricing. It creates an expectation in the client's mind that you will customize the price to their specific work scope. And this helps remove the expectation mismatch and the heartburn later. And more importantly, it ensures that you are creating a profitable CAS business model. If you lock into an unprofitable price for a year through your engagement, you have a difficult 9 months left. After 3 months, when you observe, oh, this leaves us no margin or very thin margin. And you need this way out for your CAS pricing agreement. The CAS survey results that CPA Trendlines did also showed that fixed fee pricing model is the number one most used method in CAS. Hourly billing has gone down, value pricing is still to pick up. It is easier for clients to budget for fixed outgo and remove the uncertainties. Now, let me take a couple of examples of how you can leverage technology to create your CAS offering and also help you work out correct pricing. Again, going back to the same explanation where you want to see how best to minimize your processing time using technology, I'm going to give you a couple of examples from Accounting Power, our accounting solution. And of course, we put a lot of thought in it when designing these solutions. Now, what you're seeing is an example of how you can leverage technology to figure out what's happening with multiple clients at one go. Now, we call this the CFO dashboard. It shows you all your clients that have reached some thresholds that you have defined for each client. And if you have more clients, you just keep scrolling down. You see some figures in red, some figures in black. Red are the ones where some threshold has been reached. And for each client, these thresholds can be different under each head. So what this system does is it tells you which client to look at and for what purpose right in the beginning of your day. And the system can be configured to send automatic alerts to such clients on each of these figures and thresholds. If you wish, so if you don't set those alerts, no alerts will go through. But what it does, it makes clients feel that my accountant is on top of my financials and he or she is very helpful in keeping my business on track. Technology can do a lot of work for you to create more profitability for you. Here is another example of what you can set up for your clients. We call it the client dashboard. This seems very common in many accounting softwares, but let me take just a few seconds here to tell you what it is. So this particular example shows cash balances, invoices past due, and unprinted checks. And remember, this is real time. It is like you telling the client which business actions he or she should take and when. The advisory emerges and grows from such tools. And you don't even have to spend too much time offering such services. Technology makes it happen for you, and you can again customize it for each of your clients. And the moment you train your clients to use this dashboard to the best of their abilities, you know, they'll get hooked onto this. They know that this is what I need to do, and my accountant behind the screen is making it all happen for me. When you start your CAS, you want to start with your questions. Who are your CAS buyers? And that's when the CAS Fit Wizard can help you. But you still need to identify industries, niches, key common needs, key common processes, for example. What are the problems that your buyers are looking to solve? What are the unfulfilled wants that buyers have? You want to visualize the promised land that buyers want to reach. The promised land is what you want to show to your prospects and clients, not just tell. So what will your customer see in your CAS offering? Now that is what you need to show them, and also tell them, okay, when you get this information from us, this is what is going to happen. This is how it's going to help you make better business decisions. And because CAS means you can have more client interactions, and you certainly will, you might need to reevaluate the people skills of your staff. That's because if somebody needs to talk to clients more number of times, you need to train them up on what to speak and what are the insights that they should focus on when speaking with the client. You need to also possibly train them to identify those aha moments or the power moments for you to come back and say, oh, look, this client seems to be struggling with something for the last 3 months, and this is what we can do for them. You want to reevaluate your tools, technology tools. You definitely want to reevaluate your internal processes and the client reports that you're going to send to your CAS clients. The key difference between what you're offering now and what you will offer, what I call the before and after CAS, that you need to really get to the bottom of it within the first 30 days. Your process steps, you know, which have manual movement of information, those are the things that you want to see if technology can change that for you. Collaboration, how will clients interact with your staff, for what purposes, what do clients receive from you, and the outcomes that clients can accomplish because of your CAS services. You can call it the KPIs, or you can explain to clients in terms of example, let's say the reduction in aging of receivables because of your CAS services, financing cost reduction because you're now recovering your receivables much faster, comparison with industry benchmark. For example, we have this thing called ratios in accounting power. So you can set up the industry averages, and then the software keeps computing for that client, how does the ratio compare with the industry averages? And those could be some telltale signs that you can easily pick and talk to your client about. Your client's existing vendors and customers, the moment you start offering CAS, and let's say you get into payables and receivables, you're going to start possibly interacting with those vendors and customers of your existing clients. Those are your captive prospects, and those can become your clients with or without help from your existing clients if you're already dealing with those vendors and customers. So basically what I'm trying to say here is you need to visualize everything that's going to happen after CAS comes into picture. And this you need to figure out within the first 30 days after you start your CAS practice. Now CAS is not about selecting just a particular type of client or a niche that buys all the services from you. CAS means being able to do what is best for all your clients, and hence we have these different CAS levels. You can actually focus on processes to specialize in CAS, sales tax, account payables and receivables. If you have the process expertise, and if you marry that with some niches, even better. What I would recommend based on what I've been seeing all this time is you definitely want to standardize your processes, but not like one process fits all. You want to standardize for similar client types or similar client need types. You want to create sample deliverables. Again, these are your the showcases. I remember one of my previous clients who specialized in restaurant accounting. He did a lot of accounting for fine dining restaurants. And his salesperson was a pretty simple but clever guy. He would go to a prospect restaurant owner and say, okay, show me the bills that you want to pay this week or this month. And typically a restaurant owner would just, you know, pick like 20, 30, 50, 100 bills and show the whole stack. and he'll take it aside, put it on the chair next to him so that the bills disappear from the eyesight. And then he would reach out into his bag and pull out one pager report that showed restaurant's entire operation and financial figures, profitability, prime ratios, labor costs, food costs, liquid costs, everything on just one page. So he'll say, you give me these 100 pages and I give you this. And people used to get convinced pretty quickly. His sales cycle was very, very short. And that is because he created those sample deliverables. You identify the before and after difference that clients will experience. It's not about your internal processes being different, your technology being different, but also what will your clients see very differently? And you want to bring that to their attention. Explain what they're missing out now. So when you show those deliverables, you have that opportunity to show, okay, these are the three things you're not getting now. You want to automate periodic delivery of insights. And this is something that we really focus here in our software, because it's hard to keep track. You know, let's say you have 60, 70 clients and you have maybe 10, 12 different parameters that you really monitor for your clients. You're talking of hundreds of events and instances that you might need to inform your client. So each client might get 10, 12, 30 in a month, but you want to remove your manual work for those kinds of things. So automate your periodic delivery of insights. And you want to review all the measurements after 3 months after you start working for the CAS offering for your particular client. That gives you a lot of opportunity. Now, then we come to 31 to 60 days. Once you've set your CAS foundation correctly, now is the time to chase the process. Now, this is the mantra for the next 30 days, chase the process. With similar technology and similar services, what is the real differentiator for your firm? It will be your processes, how you master your process, how you differently create your processes. You will need at least weekly, if not daily, measurement of work already done and what is pending. And this is really critical because this is what will help you make your process really strong. And in CAS, invariably, you will deliver something to the clients more frequently than just at the end of the month. And when you do so, you want to proactively seek client feedback as soon as possible. It helps you refine your processes. There's a lot of client interactions that should happen in this 31 to 60 days time period. And then the first 60 days are kind of adequate for your initial CAS learning. And then 61 to 90 days is your time for scaling your CAS practice. And here I'm going to go the opposite way. I'm going to share some insights from some firms that struggle to scale their CAS practices. And what you see on this slide are the things that such firms did not do. For example, reaching out and presenting. Okay, what do you do? Just send an email, doesn't work. If you reach out, you definitely want to show the promised land. What is it that other clients are getting? And you definitely want to explain the difference. Do not expect the clients to really know what the difference is. I remember one of my clients again, San Diego firm, mostly high net worth individuals as clients. And 20 years, 22 years in practice. He said after 19 years in public practice, he realized that clients don't really care about the balance sheet. What they care about is the meaning that comes out of the balance sheet. So he decided, okay, it is an accountant's job to maintain correct balance sheet, but it is also an accountant's job to go and tell the business owner, this is what is the story that your balance sheet is telling you now at this point in time. So explain the difference. You also want to pinpoint the missed opportunities to your clients. Okay, if you're not buying the CAS services, you might not use these words, but you're saying, okay, these are the things that can turn into cost-saving opportunities, increasing your profitability opportunities and things like that. You want to show some measurable impact than a generic thing. And then you provide peer comparison figures. This, I'm told, that one of the most favorite things once you start giving it to your existing clients, they want to really know how others in their industry are doing and what, if any, they can do to match that performance of their peers and competitors. Now, this is what you do in 61 to 90 days. You will also possibly change your marketing pitch, your sales pitch, the words on your website, because you're going to learn what your CAS clients are telling you. And if you pay close attention, you'll be able to pick a few things that will very quickly resonate with others who have similar challenges or who have similar dreams like your existing clients have. So with that, I'm going to be coming to an end of this webinar. There is a lot that we can speak on this subject. It's really hard to pack everything under the 45 minutes that we have, but I am available. Feel free to reach out to me with your specific CAS questions. We're going to be publishing even more materials. The CAS guide is available for download, and it has some really detailed stuff in there. For example, how do you identify a CAS specific technology for your firm? How do you identify your CAS clients and things like that? It's a really good guide. And here is how you can connect with me. And at Accountants World, we would love to chat. Here's our phone number. We have what is known as our specialist or practice development consultants who deal with accountants all the time. They are experts in their own field in terms of understanding how accounting works with accounting power. And of course, our website gives you a lot of information. So if there are any questions out there, I would like to take those questions now. Dave, I cannot see any questions though here. I don't know if I close the window.
No, I can help you out with that. So one question was a couple of people asked, how did they find the spreadsheet wizard that you mentioned?
Okay, good question. Yes, I actually wanted to upload it, but we missed it. We're going to email it to all the attendees. Our GoToWebinar tells us who attended. So anybody who's attended should get that in the email today itself, I guess. Yeah.
All right. Yep. That'll be by end of day today or early tomorrow at the latest.
Yes.
Next question from Dean. Do most CPA firms who are providing CAS offer clients past due accounts receivable collection services or anything related to that?
Collections is a separate service as we experience based on our interactions. But accountant receivable services definitely is something that is picking up. You're bringing to your client's attention, okay, these are the overdue things. And if you don't collect, you have cash flow issues next week, next month, and things like that. In fact, we built that into accounting power as well, where with one click of a button, you can actually receive money for your clients in the client's accounts. It's like an electronic system that sends a receivable invoice to the vendors, to the customers of your clients, and they can click on that invoice right in their email, put in their bank account number and routing number just one time. They're not sharing that private detail with anyone. They're doing it in their offices. And that's once they click on that and they give those details, the money is moved into the client's bank account. So even there, a lot of automation has happened.
All right. A couple of people, including Joellen, asked, how do you compare client progress versus industry standards? Do you use ProfitSense or some other tool?
We actually look at industry standards as indicators rather than finite, exclusive, pinpointed figures of profit and all that. So basically what you're talking about is financial ratios. And for each industry, the financial ratios could be different. And if you work with similar types of clients, it's easier for you to know what those ratios are. You can possibly do some Google research and set them up. At least in accounting power, we have a separate place for that. So you set up industry benchmarks for those 10, 15 ratios that we have included. And then accounting power actually computes for each of those ratios, what is the client score based on the accounts that are maintaining accounting power. And then it compares it with these ratios. And some ratios can tell you a big story. For example, crime ratio in terms of restaurant accounting, if it goes above 63-64%, it's a telltale sign that the restaurant is going to have a lot of financial issues. So anything below 63%, the restaurant owner can sleep peacefully at night.
Okay, I know we're running up against time here. One more question I'll go ahead and get to. And folks, if we didn't answer your question right here, I'll go ahead and forward them afterwards, or my team will forward them to Hitendra, and he'll try to get a response back to you. One last one, is it difficult to transition from other accounting programs to the one that you've shown recently here?
Well, that's a standard question across the industry, and we, of course, identify that. And typically from another solution, if you want to transfer into Accounting Power, we have integrations built in. So from some of the leading softwares, you can just go to that software and export and bring it back into Accounting Power right through Accounting Power screens. And for other softwares, maybe not so frequently used softwares, there is what we call the generic imports. So you can export from other software, put them into Excel in the columns that we recommend, and bring that Excel in, and that brings in. But for the top softwares that are very predominantly used in the profession, you can actually go right through Accounting Power and bring it in.
Okay, so we're just about to run out of time here. So I wanted to just thank Hitendra for joining us today and for all the expertise that you've been able to provide. As I mentioned, Hitendra has the assessment wizard, and we'll be getting that out to you as well in one form or another. Also, I wanted to remind you our next expert webinar is coming up on August 13th. Eric Askerson, the president and CEO of CPA.com, we'll be talking about how to perform high quality prep, comp, and review engagements. So hope you join us for that. That's 2 weeks from today, same time at 2 p.m. Eastern. And you can sign up for all of this year's expert webinars at 2019webinars.com, all one word, 2019webinars.com, and sign up for all of them in less than a minute. So thanks again to Hitendra for joining us today, and thanks to all of you as well for joining us today. And we look forward to seeing you at our next webinar very soon.